I'm Lisa Blonet, and I'm tapping into the social media street. Wendy Williams' son, Kevin Jr., discloses that his mother's alcoholism was the cause of her frontal temporal dementia. She also suffers from aphasia, a condition that impacts a person's speech, and frontal temporal dementia, a disorder impacting behavior and cognitive functions, have already taken a toll on Wendy's life. Watchers of Where is Wendy Williams? Soon realized that the former radio and television personality is not in a good place right now. The four-part Lifetime docuseries debuted just this past weekend. They cut the camera on and started filming in 2022 when Wendy Williams was talking about her wish to go back to television and looking like her old self. Reasons are initially unclear to us, but then they become increasingly evident as her financial and physical conditions become more apparent. Kevin Jr., her only child, says that it was alcohol-induced. The doctors said that she was drinking so much that it started to affect her headspace and her brain. Now, if you didn't know, Wendy Williams, who is 59 years old, first learned about her brain damage in 2019 when she entered a Florida rehab facility. But she didn't receive the official dementia and aphasia diagnosis until 2023. There you have it. And this is what I was talking about. And alcohol, I believe strongly, is one. And this is where I make my point. This can happen to any of us. And the lifestyle that she led and the type of lifestyle that she was living when she was younger, she didn't do it by herself. She wasn't partying alone. And although this is heartbreaking, this is a classic example of you reap what you sow. In reflection of what is going on, let us be mindful of our decisions that we make in our 20s, our 30s, hell, in our 60s. Too much of anything is a bad thing. And when you overindulge in things that you know are not good for your body, they will eventually catch up to you. Take heed, you guys. And remember, your body will never forget what you've done to it. And it will start to show up in ways as you get older that may not be conducive to your lifestyle. Don't become a victim of your own circumstances, you guys. Don't become a victim of your own choices in life. Don't let your bad choices catch up to you, because eventually they will. Let's all be aware and mindful of our decisions that we make in life before they have us knocking on heaven's door.
The one thing that I said about the documentary is please don't let people sugarcoat their responses and their revelations regarding who Wendy is, who she was, and what they saw.
I want their truth in the documentary.
People are saying this is her karma. People are saying that because she was outspoken, that, you know, this is somehow what she deserves. You guys let me know in the comments what you think.
I just want to thank everybody for listening, because although you might think I sit up here and diss and everything like that, I'm just a positive person trying to do a positive thing, trying to have a little bit of fun and make my mark in the world.
Thank you very much for listening to KISS. Really.
Wendy, why do you diss people?
Oh, Ralph, let me tell you something. I heard something about you. If you turn off the camera, I'll tell you exactly what it is.
Baby, come and get your boo. Oh, yeah. Session trying to get all in my boo.